Good morning, students. Welcome back to the chemistry class. I hope you all are safe and sound at your home and taking good care of yourself. Today, I will continue with the same chapter number 4, that is atomic structure. Let's start the topic chemical formula. Chemical formula, also known as molecular formula. Chemical formula means it shows one molecule of an element, or you can say chemical formula shows one molecule of the compound. Students, do you remember the difference between elements and the compounds? Can you tell me what is the difference between element and compound? Let's revise. Elements, they are made up of the same kind of atoms or atoms of the same elements. Okay? Hydrogen molecule, chlorine molecule, nitrogen molecule, etc. One molecule of hydrogen contains how many atoms of hydrogen? Two atoms of the hydrogen. One molecule of chlorine contains how many chlorine atoms? Two chlorine atoms. One molecule of the nitrogen contains how many atoms of nitrogen? Two nitrogen atoms. Okay? Please remember, same elements. Okay? Now, over here in compounds, compounds are made up of the atoms of the different elements. For example, H2O is a compound. HCl is a compound. Ammonia, NH3 is a compound. Now, why H2O is a compound? Because I can see there are two elements, hydrogen also and oxygen also. So, how many hydrogen atoms are there? Two hydrogen atoms. And how many oxygen atoms? Only one oxygen atom in one molecule of the water. So, water is a compound. HCl is also a compound. How many hydrogen atoms? One hydrogen atom. And how many chlorine atom? One chlorine atom. And HCl molecule is formed. Students, we all know that atoms combine, or we can say atoms join together to form molecules. Can you tell me the reason why do atoms combine? Few atoms are not stable. So, to get the stability, they combine and they form molecules. Now, these molecules are very stable. So, we can say a molecule is the smallest particle of an element or a compound which has independent existence because it is very stable. Students, just as a symbol represents one atom, for example, if I want to show sodium atom, I will be writing its symbol, that is Na. If I want to represent one atom of aluminium, I will be writing a symbol for it, that is Al. Similarly, the chemical formula represents one molecule of the element or a compound. Over here, we are studying right now chemical formula of the element. So, we are going to define the chemical formula of the element as the formula which is representing the actual number of the atoms present in one molecule of the element. How many molecules of the element? One molecule of the element. How many atoms are present? Okay? So, over here, for the representation of the chemical formula, we are concerned only with the number of the atoms present in one molecule. Okay? For example, one molecule of the hydrogen. The chemical formula for the hydrogen will be H2. Okay? This is very stable and the chemical formula is H2. Means one molecule of the hydrogen can be represented with a chemical formula H2. Number of hydrogen atoms. This 2 is showing the number of the hydrogen atoms. How many? There are 2 hydrogen atoms. The 2 in the chemical formula tells that one molecule of the hydrogen element contains 2 atoms of the hydrogen. Now, let us understand these elements. Okay? Oxygen element is there. Now, if it is written like O, just O, it means one atom of oxygen. Okay? If you are writing it as O2, O and small number at the down, it means this is a molecule, one molecule of the oxygen. okay? And how many atoms in one molecules? This small number will show the number of the atoms. 2 atoms of oxygen in one molecule of the oxygen, okay? Now 2O2, just O2 shows one molecule of the oxygen. If I write in front of the formula 2, now it becomes 2 molecules of the oxygen. Okay? If I make it 3O2, if I write, then it means 3 molecules of oxygen. 4O2, if I write, it is 4 molecules of oxygen. Okay? And so on. So the number which is in front of the formula, it shows the number of the molecules. Okay? Now, over here, this is 2O. If I just hide it, then it is just O. O is what? One atom of oxygen. Now, if I write in front of it 2, then it means 2 atoms of oxygen. Okay? Now, if I write 3O, it means 3 atoms of oxygen. If I write 4O, it means 4 atoms of oxygen. Clear? Now, over here, O3, it is a molecule which is representing ozone. Okay? So, one molecule of ozone having how many atoms? This number will tell you number of the atoms, which is 3. Okay? 3 atoms are present in one molecule of the ozone. Ozone is written as O3. Clear, class? Let us understand the formation of hydrogen chloride. During the formation of hydrogen chloride, hydrogen combines with chlorine. Over here, in front of hydrogen, is there any number present? No. So, this is one molecule of hydrogen. In front of chlorine, is there any number? No. So, this is one molecule of the chlorine. So, when one molecule of hydrogen combines with one molecule of chlorine, how many molecules of hydrogen chloride are formed? What is the number over here? 2. So, 2 molecules of hydrogen chloride are formed. Okay. Over here, one molecule of the hydrogen is represented as H2. So, how many hydrogen atoms are present? 2 hydrogen atoms are present. One molecule of chlorine is represented as Cl2. So, how many chlorine atoms are present? 2 chlorine atoms are present. So, these two are the elements. But over here, I can see in this molecule, hydrogen element as well as the chlorine element is present. So, hydrogen atoms as well as chlorine atoms are present. So, this is not an element. It is a compound. Okay, class? Let us study few more examples of the molecular formula of some common elements. So, this is the row for the elements. This is for the formula, or you can say chemical formula. This is the atomicity. Okay, what is atomicity? Atomicity is the number of the atoms present in one molecule of an element. Okay, over here, these all are showing one molecule of the elements. For example, hydrogen. So, one molecule of hydrogen is represented as H2. And what is its atomicity? How many atoms in one molecule? What is the number over here? 2. So, 2 atoms of hydrogen in one molecule. Helium. Helium, one molecule is represented as He. And atomicity, how many atoms? Only 1 atom in one molecule of helium. Oxygen is represented as O2. So, this is one molecule of oxygen. Okay. And what is its atomicity? 2. So, 2 atoms are present of oxygen. Sulfur, one molecule of sulfur represented as S8. And 8 is the atomicity for the one molecule of sulfur. Means 8 atoms are present in one molecule of sulfur. Okay. Phosphorus, represented as P4. One molecule of phosphorus has 4 atoms of phosphorus. So, atomicity is 4. Nitrogen, one molecule of nitrogen is N2. And how many atoms in one molecule of nitrogen? 2 atoms of nitrogen. Hence, its atomicity is 2. Bromine, one bromine molecule is represented as Br2. So, how many atoms of bromine? 2 atoms of bromine. Atomicity will be 2. Chlorine, One chlorine molecule is represented as Cl2. So, how many atoms of chlorine present in one molecule? Two atoms of chlorine present. Hence, its atomicity is 2. Okay, class? Now, let's see formulae of some common compounds. Carbon dioxide. The formula will be CO2. It means one carbon atom and two oxygen atoms. One carbon and two oxygen atoms. Ammonia, it's a compound because two elements are there, nitrogen and hydrogen. Nitrogen, how many atoms? One nitrogen atom and three hydrogen atoms. Sulfuric acid, it's a compound. It's not an element because sulfuric acid is H2SO4. Three elements are there, hydrogen, sulfur and oxygen. And how many atoms? Hydrogen, two atoms, sulfur, one atom and four oxygen atoms. Okay, children? Now, this is the list of the names of some common compounds. You need to learn these names, okay? Carbon monoxide. The formula, chemical formula will be CO. Mono means one oxygen. So, carbon and one oxygen atom. One carbon atom and one oxygen atom. Carbon dioxide. Di means two oxygen. So, carbon dioxide CO2. Carbon 1 and oxygen 2 atoms. Sulfur dioxide. Di means again 2 oxygen atoms. So, sulfur SO2. Sulfur dioxide. Sulfur trioxide. Over here, tri means 3 oxygen atoms. So, sulfur S and O3. SO3. Carbon tetrachloride. Carbon tetra means 4 chlorine atoms. Carbon C and Cl4, carbon tetrachloride. Phosphorus pentoxide, phosphorus P2O5. This is a formula for the phosphorus pentoxide. Penta means 5 oxygen. Okay. Ammonia, 1 nitrogen atom and 3 hydrogen atoms. Hydrogen peroxide, H2O2, 2 hydrogen atom and 2 oxygen atom. Hydrochloric acid HCl, 1 hydrogen atom and 1 chlorine atom. Nitric acid HNO3, 1 hydrogen, 1 nitrogen and 3 oxygen atoms. Sulfuric acid H2SO4, 2 hydrogen atom, 1 sulfur atom and 4 oxygen atom. Phosphorus pentachloride PCl5, penta means 5 chlorine atoms, right? PCl5. Okay, one phosphorus atom and 5 chlorine atoms. Students, can you tell me how many molecules of ammonia are there? This shows 3 molecules of ammonia. How many molecules of carbon dioxide? This shows 2 molecules of carbon dioxide. How many molecules of sulfur dioxide? This shows 4 molecules of sulfur dioxide. How many molecules of carbon dioxide? As there is no number in front of the chemical formula, so it is understood it is 1 molecule of carbon dioxide. How many molecules of nitrogen? This shows 5 molecules of nitrogen. Now the topic is radicals. Let us understand radicals. Children, both atoms and molecules are neutral in nature. However, there are some atoms or molecules which carry a positive charge or a negative charge on them. These species are known as radicals or ions. So, we can define radical as a radical is an atom or a group of atoms of the same or different elements with a positive or a negative charge. A radical is defined as a single atom of an element or a group of atoms of different elements carrying a positive or a negative charge. So over here, what is important? A charge on them. If they have either a positive charge or a negative charge, then that particular species will be known as radical, or you can say it's an ion. So radicals or the ions are divided into two types: positive radicals and negative radicals. The radicals or the ions that are positively charged. Can you see the positive charge? Na positive, Ca2 positive, Al3 positive. These are positively charged. So these are known as positive radicals or positive ions, you can say. Or these are known as cations. Positive charged ions are known as cations. Please remember this. Negative radicals means radicals are the ions which have a negative charge on them. So they are known as the negative radicals. They are also known as anions. Okay. Positive are known as cations. Negative, they are known as anions. So over here we can say it is a sodium cation, calcium cation, aluminium cation, and so on. Here we will say chloride anion, bromide anion, carbonate anion. Okay, so on the basis of the positive charge and the negative charge, the ions or the radicals divided into two types, cations and the anions. Okay. Now let us understand the formula of some common radicals. The radicals are divided into two parts, simple radicals and complex radicals. Simple radicals, by looking at them, you can say that the radicals, they are the charged atoms of the same element. Okay, of the same elements, simple radicals. Complex radicals, they are the charged species where the atoms are of different elements. In this, sulfur atom is also there, oxygen atom is also there. Carbonate radical, carbon atom also, oxygen also is there. So these types of the radicals, they are known as the complex radicals. Okay. Here chloride radical can be shown as a Cl negative. You can say it as chloride ion also. You can term it as chloride anion also, right? Bromide radical, Br single negative. Iodide ion or iodide radical, it's I single negative. Fluoride radical or fluoride anion or chloride ion, right? This is F single negative. Oxide radical, O2 negative. Sulfate is written as SO42 negative. Carbonate radical is known as CO32 negative. Okay, please remember these.